Josh Kelley, thanks for coming to the Press Shop.
Thanks for having me, guys. This is awesome. So my name is Josh Kelley. This first song I'm going to do is a song that I wrote for my lovely wife because she puts up with all us knuckleheads at the house. This is called Loves You Like Me. They might know your name and they might know your face, but I dare say they don't know your heart. They've only seen you all put together, they ain't never seen you fall apart. They don't know who you are. But I get to watch you kissing the curls on the top of our baby girl's head, and I get to hold you while we fall asleep in the middle of our king-size bed. Everyone loves you, but nobody loves you like me. Yeah, everyone loves you, but nobody loves you like me. Nobody loves you like me. To the crowd in the room, you're the life of the party. To me, you're my reason to live. I run out of steam where you're just getting started. It's hard not to love your best friend. Everyone loves you, but nobody loves you like me. Cause I get to watch you run through the rain in the parking lot down at the mall, and I can't count the times you've kissed away pain and you pick me back when I fall. Everyone loves you, but nobody loves you like me. Yeah, everyone loves you, but nobody loves you like me. Nobody loves you like me. I watch the shade of your beautiful eyes change with the rise of the sun. I'm the only one. I'm the only one. Yeah, I'm the only one. I got to watch you light up the room down the aisle with that wedding dress on, and I got to dance with the lady that everyone wishes that they could take home. Everyone loves you, but nobody loves you like me. Yeah, everyone loves you, but nobody loves you like me. Nobody loves you like me. Nobody loves you like me. Nobody. Nobody loves you. Loves you like me.
Josh Kelley, thanks for coming to the Press Shop.
Dude, thank you for having me. This is an honor. This is awesome.
Loves you like me.
Yeah.
So I'm assuming that's about your wife.
It is. And yeah. I can quickly tell you actually where the music came from. It's kind of weird. I got on our version of Craigslist in Utah, and this person had a piano on there, and it said free. And I was like, oh, neat. You know, really nice big upright piano. And so I called the person up, and they were like, yeah, it's free, but you have to pay $50 for this, you know, for the get it over to you. And I was like, done. They brought it in. The very first chords out of my hands were those chords for Loves You Like Me. And it was just pretty chords to me at the time. But I'm a firm believer that instruments have something to say. And those chords led to all of a sudden just kind of humming a melody. And I started writing a song for Katie because she is the backbone of our family, big time. I mean, without her, dude, I would have a beard down to my ankles and I would never see the sunlight. She's turned me into like a semi-normal human, so I'm very grateful for her, and she puts up with us. And so I wrote a song for her, and it took me a while. I found that last verse, and I was riding my bike, and I was going up this hill, and I knew that it needed a third verse, and I wrote the whole thing, dictating it into my phone while I was riding a bike. Just waited on it, you know. I wrote the song a year before, and then a year later, the third verse and what really sort of made it a whole piece came together.
Oh, I've heard creation sing, and it brought me to my knees. Still, it just can't seem to find a song as beautiful as you. I've seen most every kind of sunrise and make the toughest cowboy cry. Still, it just can't seem to paint the sky as beautiful as you. Hallelujah, you're my angel, the very reason I believe that there must be someone up there. Hallelujah, you're my angel. Oh, I felt the winter's cold and freeze a man. Never have I shaken more than when I first held you. Oh, I've loved and I have lost, broken bridges I have crossed. Now I'm in debt to all that brought me right here with you. Hallelujah. You're my angel, the very reason I believe that there must be someone up there. Hallelujah, you're my angel. We're alone.
Thing that helps is comedy, and yes. you're a funny guy.
I love doing it. Yeah. I just don't care, and I think that really helps.
Not taking yourself so seriously goes a long way.
Yeah.
But when you do that and you sit down and deliver this unbelievable voice that you have, it's a really special thing, particularly when you are doing these imitations. And I'm guessing that you do quite a few voices.
Yeah.
You nailed Sean Mullins and Michael McDonald in the same song.
Yeah, there's a bunch. And you can also come down here like this, and you can do like Luther Van, anything. So, yeah, we do a bunch of weird stuff at home. We're goofy people, man.
Yeah, we are too. But awesome. Having fun that's what life's about, man.
Yeah, yeah.
And this is a prime example. This project just really wasn't thought out. It just kind of happened.
Yeah.
I told you, and now it's turned into this. And these experiences and the people that I've met along the way, and I say this in a few interviews, but there's so many different types of currency. Money's only one of them. And, buddy, I am getting paid back right now by you being here.
Love it. Really. Thanks, appreciate man. It. No, thank you for having me. This is an honor. And honestly, it's so cool to be able to do these things. And you're right. When you put settings and things like this together and it starts off at hello, it's just, this is fun for me. Mm-hmm. I love doing this. You know what I mean? You're creating something. It's usually more than not going to be successful because you didn't start from a place, you know, like I'm doing this for money.
Right.
Or, you know.
Certainly didn't do it for that.
Yeah. I think whenever sure. I've written songs or been a part of songs and I'm having a great time, I'm telling you, it's like 90% success rate on that project or whatever it is being successful. And I don't know what it is, but I guess, you know, happiness and smiles is a big part of the recipe, right? Yeah. From what a food I find out that it's all about the way that you kiss my neck early in the morning when we're lying in bed. Last night tossing and turning, got your hair in a mess. About the way that you understand that sweet, sexy way that you hurt this man. Kissing those lips got me feeling so free inside. So if you wanna be loved, I got it. If you wanna make love, I can do that too. If you wanna be tough in the right way, baby, flip on the lights so I can see my masterpiece tonight, Lord. Do, 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 do. Whoa, Lord, Lord, Lord. Sitting by the fire with a glass of wine. That fur coat robe got me looking so fly. Cheers to you, honey, cause you look so money tonight, Lord. Oh, I'm crazy about the way that you shake your thing and make me want to give you a diamond ring. Let's finish what we started, cause baby, you're a part of my life. So if you wanna be loved, got it. If you wanna make love, I can do that too. If you wanna be tough in the right way, baby, flip on the lights so I can see my masterpiece tonight. More and more each time, you know I need it. That's my background singers. I realize our love's just a crime. You know I want it. You got me bending over backwards just to catch you on the other side. West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playground. It's where I spend most of my days. Chilling out back and relaxing all cool and shooting some b-ball outside the school when a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared. She said, you're moving with your auntie and your uncle in Bel Air. I said, I whistled for a cab and when it came near, the license plate suppression had a dice in the mirror. If anything, I can tell this cab was rare. I pulled up to the house about 7:08 and I yelled to the cab, yo homie, smell you later. I looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as a prince of Bel Air. I said, love, I got it. If you want to make love, I can do that too. If you want to be tough in the right way, baby, flip on the light so I can see my masterpiece tonight. Baby, flip on the light so I can see my masterpiece tonight. Yeah.
I've been trying to learn how to sing. Okay.
Do
this is a thing with me. I have like 10 voices. Welcome to your world, right? told a friend of mine, I was like, I can't find my voice. Sometimes I'm trying to sing different ways. And so Francisco said, I'm going to teach you how to sing and we're going to use this song, I'm on Fire by Bruce Springsteen.
Oh, great.
And then so you started performing that tonight. Yeah. And I was like, Fran, you think I should get up there and show him how it's done? Which awesome. Would not be a good idea at all.
Shoot.
But you pulled it off beautifully. And it was a really cool incarnation of that song. Tell me why you chose that song.
It was an accident. It was years ago, and I was just doing this right here. And, you know, it can be anything, but you're doing this, for lack of better words, kind of like a Johnny Cash style of picking. And I just started singing I'm on Fire, Hey, little girl, is your daddy home? And I was like, oh, neat. You know, this is actually works really cool for this. Because, you know, normally the song is, you know. Mm-hmm. And I really like this sort of slower, alternate picking kind of style of this song. Because the song, the original, it's actually really short, too. Mm-hmm. It's a super short song. And I wanted to draw it out a little bit and turn it into a different kind of experience. And I got really lucky, man. I'd performed it for probably a year and then decided to record it just one day out of the blue. And I think like 30 minutes later after producing the song, I was like, well, this is done.
Yeah.
You know, I think I'd done it so many times that I just, everything was like one take and just super simple production. I literally am playing a kick and the hi-hat. And that's it. No snare, no nothing. Just that's it. And it's just, it leaves all this space in the production and in the mix to be open, to be able to use beautiful reverbs and things mm-hmm. like that to actually start balancing out the production.
Got a bad desire. Ooh, I'm on fire. Tell me, pretty mama, is it good to you? Can he do to you the things that I do? I can take you higher. Ooh, I'm on fire. Sometimes it's like someone took a knife, baby, itchy and dull, and cut a 6-inch valley through the middle of my soul. At night I wake up with the sheets soaking wet and a freight train running through the middle of my head. Only you can cool my desires. I'm on fire. Ooh, I'm on fire. Oh, 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 oh. Mm-hmm.
You know, fame is a bitch. I know some famous people, and I know you do as well.
I'm not very famous, but my wife got extremely famous right when we started dating, and it scared the living shit out of me.
Really?
Yeah.
You being followed around?
It's just such a foreign concept of people chasing you. You know, like, I'm just trying to drive my wife somewhere, and there's like 30, 40 cars, and they're like causing wrecks behind you, and it's because they're trying to get, at the time, shots that were worth a lot of money. And all I used to have dreams about taking their camera and smashing it in their face. And Really? I mean, and which is not very good for me to be thinking those things, but it was so much anxiety paired with it all that I just really hated all that.
And that caught you guys kind of by surprise too, right?
There's definitely no... Yeah, because she's not the kind of person who's ever done what she does to be famous. It just was one of those things. When it hit hard, and luckily everybody loves her, and so they really wanted a piece of her. That's pretty wild, man.
It is wild to make it to that level, you know, so fast, and to be blindsided by something like that.
Yeah, and me from Georgia, I don't think we weren't prepared for that.
Right.
Sing down the sun, shine down your song, so that it might guide me back. Some light on the darkest of days, so that we might not lose our way. So holy, holy, holy Lord, holy my me.
right when you got here, we started talking about golf.
Yeah.
You know, I knew that you were a golfer. I didn't know you were a Division One golfer. So can you kind of walk me through this? You're at Ole Miss, and music kind of took you. I mean, I guess it was probably part of your life.
It's been part of my life since I was a little kid.
Yeah.
And I always knew that I wanted to do it for a living. And I just remember everybody being like, no, there's no way, dude. People are born into that. And I was like, I don't think they are. I think they just work hard. But so there was always sort of a struggle of like, what am I better at, golf or music? And then I careered a really big junior tournament, an AJJ tournament, when I was in high school, and that got me into Division I college golf. Really, I had no business being in Division I. I just careered one huge tournament.
You just lit it up?
I lit it up.
Three-day tournament or two-day tournament?
It was a two-day tournament, and I won because my dad told me to take the driver and the three-wood out of the bag.
Yeah.
I hit a one-iron off the tee. I've always been kind of a longer hitter, and I just hit every damn fairway with this one iron, and I won the tournament.
Holy shit.
And then I got, and it's what's great is it took me to Ole Miss, and I was just far enough away from my parents and everybody that I kind of, it's almost like I started a new life. And then music started really taking over, and I started playing shows every Thursday at the Sneaky Tiki, and went from playing in front of 10 people to almost 1,000 every Thursday.
Tell me about Amazing. So you write the song, Amazing, and then crazy things start happening.
Yeah, it just, out of the blue, I mean, I wrote this song, and I remember when I wrote it too, and I had been writing a lot, and I felt like they were, good songs, but when I wrote Amazing, I really did know. I was like, this is special. And it was more just the music and the melody. The message, I was still learning how to be a writer that really can deliver a cool message, but you know, to me, the most important thing was that it sounded cool, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I put the song on Napster, and then I came up with this little scheme because I really wanted people to hear my music. And I was like, how can I make this little puddle into a pond, into a river, into a giant body of water? I want as many people to fall into as possible. And I found this like loophole in Napster and totally exploited it.
Just reaching out to your fans.
Well, what I did is I was in the library, which is the only place that had really fast internet, and they had a firewall. So what I would do is I noticed one day it was an accident. I right-clicked on somebody's unique username on Napster, and a little box came up, and it said, message. And I was like, oh, crap, can I send this person a message? And so I did. I sent somebody a message. They sent back, like, hey, I love this. This is great. So I came up with a plan. My plan was to basically type in a different person's name every day and send 100 unique people a message saying, hey, I noticed you like James Taylor or Stevie Wonder or whatever at the time. Why don't you try out this kid named Josh Kelley I just found. You're going to love him. I did it 100 times a day for a couple months and literally had a record deal like within 3 months.
And that was a $1 billion idea.
Yeah. Yeah. Now I know.
Yeah.
It was social media before social media. What an idiot.
You paint a picture on the wall, 'cause you've got a lot to tell me, but you don't think you can say it better. Oh, baby, you're bringing up times I can't recall, and I'm sure they made your point, but I just can't seem to remember. Yeah, and I know you got the feeling, and I can't say I'm agreeing with your topic of conversation. So just listen to the reasons and the hints that I've been given to the thoughts of my imagination. So come on, let me sing. I said, baby, you're amazing. I want to let you see. Are you everything and more to me? I will let you be. I will, 'cause I saw you walking down the hall, and I had a lot to tell you, but I didn't think you could say it better. Oh, baby, now, you were good at making me feel so small, and I know you made your point, but I just don't want to remember. And I know you got the feeling, and I can't say I'm agreeing with your topic of conversation. So then listen to the resist my rock stance. I've been given to the thoughts of my imagination. Come on, let me sing. I said, baby, you're amazing. I want to let you see you are everything and more to me. Your baby love, now I will let you be. I will. Cause I'm dancing around in your world of play, taking my time to make sure you stay. I would give my life to make it okay. Yeah, come on, let me sing. I said, la-di-da-di, now we like to party. We don't cause trouble, we don't bother nobody. We're just some people who be rocking the mic. And when we rock upon the mic, we rock the mic. Oh, you dogs keeping y'all in house. And it's just to you smile and enjoy yourself. Cause it's a cool and a calm and a cozy condition, which we create cause that's our mission. So now listen, not close to what we say. This type of happens every day. And I woke up around 6 o'clock in the morning. Gave myself a stretch and I'm up and up and yawning. Use out of a lake cause my skin gets pale, it does. I used to file for my fingernail. I said I'm true to the style on my behalf. I put the bubbles in the tub so I can take a bubble bath. Clean, dry was my body and hair. I threw on my brand new doggy underwear. Brown numbers I might take on. I got the Johnson baby powder and Kawada cologne. I said not fresh, dressed like a million freaking bucks. Threw on my white shoes and my old blue jump. Fell out the house, fair show, oh no. I went back in, I forgot my endo. I said, baby, you're amazing. It's like Sean. I want to let you see you everything and more to me. I will let you be. I will let you be, Lord. I said, now, baby, you're amazing. I want to let you. Everything and more to me. I will let you be. I will.
I can tell your family means a lot to you.
Yes.
My family does too. It's everything. And your music speaks to that. Your performance today, really, again, just it blew me away. I was
thanks,
touched.
Man.
I was entertained. I laughed. I got a little misty eyed. You know, it was the whole gamut of the emotions. It was a great time. It really was.
That's the purpose of it.
You had a couple songs that you sang about your daughters.
Yes.
One of the lyrics, and I wrote it down because it spoke to me immediately, and it says, I couldn't see past me until I saw you.
Yes.
And sweet.
Sweet Naylee Moon. Moon. Yeah.
Yeah. And that's a combination of your daughter's name. Is that right?
Yeah. So Naylee, basically when my wife was growing up, her sister was adopted from South Korea.
Mm-hmm.
And so she grew up in that diverse family. And when we were dating, and she could tell, like, we were getting to a place where I might ask her to marry her pretty soon and mm-hmm. marry me. And
she was terrified.
She was, no, actually, I started getting terrified. But she's one of her things, she goes, I just want to let you know, I really want to adopt first. She goes, are you okay with that? And I said, yeah, like, what kind of asshole says no?
Right.
Like, who goes, no, I'm really not into, like, saving children these days. It's just not a part of my life design. It's like, what? But I guess people do. And I was like, absolutely. And then when it came down to it, and we already had found our match, and they sent us her picture, and she was going to be here in a few months, I started getting nervous. I was like, what if she doesn't like me? You know, mm-hmm. what if she doesn't bond with me? And I started getting really nervous. And my wife told me that she prayed on it, and she just knew that when she put that baby in my arms, that you know, it was over from there. And she was right. The first time I got to hold her and she put her little hand on my face as if to say that she accepted me as her new dad, just melted.
I know the kind of guy I am. I've bit too much into myself, not much left for someone else. And I'm sure I caused my share of pain, but all that changed when you first touched my face. Halfway around my little world, you had no idea that you were my girl. You found my arms not a moment too soon. I couldn't see past me till I saw you, sweet Nayli Moon. I love the man you're making me. Yeah, every day I wanna prove there's nothing I won't do for you. Just to see you in your mama's arms is more than enough to bring me to my knees. Halfway around my little world, you had no idea that you were my girl. You found my arms on a moment too soon. I couldn't see past all you, sweet Nayli Moon. Whoa, I can't imagine life without my Nayli Moon. Halfway around my little world, you had no you were my girl. You found my arms not a moment too soon. I couldn't see past me till I saw you. I couldn't see past me till I saw you.
Discovering new music. You're not a new artist, but you're new music to me, right?
Yeah.
So discovering this now and having you over here, it's just like, where the fuck have I been? You know, I think I'm a
reinvented artist though. So in a sense, I am new for a lot of people because I've reinvented myself and become better and better writer. And so I've been around for a while, but really I think, you know, the new me has been around since 2014.
Francisco and I were having a conversation in the kitchen and he's like, you know, I heard Josh Kelley perform many years ago and he was good. Now he's great.
Oh,
you're one of those voices that has matured, you know, over the years and just gotten better.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm very grateful for that because, you know, back in the day, you know, artists, they were allowed to develop and you have to develop, mm-hmm. you know, it takes a while. Nowadays, you know, if somebody doesn't have a hit or something right out of the gate, if they throw it against the wall and if it doesn't stick, it's like their career is over.
Mm-hmm.
And that's really sad because, you know, developing an artist is a really big part of the investment. And I feel like a lot of people in the business just have it so wrong. I mean, mm-hmm. it's taken me a long time to get to where I feel like I'm good at this. And now I love it, but I'm really glad I never gave up. Shit. I mean, what if I'd have given up? That sucks.
Well, thanks for coming, man. We have had an absolute blast. You're an authentic guy. You're a true artist, and I am glad to know you, man.
Me too. Thank you so much.
Best of luck to you, brother.
You too, brother. Thank you.
I never saw this day in my brain when I was carving out the rest of my life. Two little girls and one little boy making angels on the snow-white skies. But I'm grateful for the changes and the plans that I once made. Cause they had me running like a rabbit on a wheel, too busy making empty dreams. And now I'm busy making memories, busy making memories. I'm busy making memories. I got a call from my dad the other day, and we got to talking about where the time go. Reminiscing in the years gone by, I felt a sadness coming through that phone. I said, don't act like life is over. You got a long one left to live. So caught up in the coulda, woulda, shoulda years, too busy in your history. When you could be busy making memories, busy making memories. You could be busy making memories. Whoa. Through the eyes of this camera, I'll take it all. Every single moment we'll carry on. In the doorframe of this lived-in home, there's a pin hanging from a string. It writes the tale of a husband and a wife, steady growing up their family. You know, one of them's a thinker, one's getting taller every day. The other only cares about the dating scene, but I tell you that's okay with me. Cause she's busy making memories, busy making memories for this ever-growing family. Oh, spinning like angels right in front of me. Whoa.
Got time for one song?
This one's called Lover Boy. This is an oronym. I discovered this on a plane by accident. So the verses are Lover Boy, and then in the chorus it's Love Her Boy. And so I found it on the internet, said it's an oronym. I don't know.
Hey, Lover Boy, what are you doing? Why you there looking sad with an empty glass, acting bad while she is back home wishing you'd make it all right? Hey there, lover boy, don't be so stupid. Don't let your stubborn pride say you're right when you know you're wrong. It's time to fight for the one thing you need in your life. So turn all them wrongs into right. Boy, all you gotta do, all you gotta do, all you gotta do is love her, boy. All you gotta do, all you gotta do, all you gotta do is love her, boy. Hey, love her, boy. Go look in the mirror and see she's the best thing you ever had, and you got a chance to get her back, but the whiskey won't fix what you broke. So put down the glass and get home, boy. All you gotta do, all you gotta do, all you gotta do is love her, boy. Got to do, all you gotta do, all you gotta do is love her, boy. Ooh. lights, boy. All you gotta do, all you gotta do, all you gotta do is love her, boy. Give her all that you have now. All you gotta do, all you gotta do, all you gotta do is love her, boy. I'm begging you, please, child. All you gotta do, all you gotta do, is love her, boy.
I can't believe my voice held up for that song. Holy shit.
Josh Kelley. He's a real deal. Man, it was a pleasure.
Thanks,
man.
Brother. Man, thank I appreciate so it, dude. This was so much fun, man. Awesome. Seriously, you're a badass. Yeah. That was fun, man.
Let me take her mind. They say
Josh shows up, his guitar's right there, he's playing with fishing poles and Xboxes.
This is from the tour bus, the Xbox, my kids are gonna love it.
Josh Kelley, Division I golfer. Here we go.
Former Division I.
That was in the drink.